Welcome to episode 2 of our Ireland and Iceland vlog series with Celebrity Cruises. In episode 1, after a night in Dublin, we took a train to the southwest to collect a car at the Kerry Airport. We then drove to Limerick visiting King John's Castle, followed by a drive to visit the Cliffs of Moher. Afterwards, we continued north for a night of great Irish music in Sligo. Today we make the drive from Sligo to Ardara to meet Eddie Doherty before returning to Dublin.
Today we're heading into Ardara, as we were told our correct pronunciation last night from our crack addicts friends. We're headed to see Mr. Doherty.
Please subscribe to our channel and select the bell to receive notifications of our new content. Thank you. The 5-kilometer drive from Sligo to Ardara was quite enjoyable, but nothing was as great as meeting Eddie. At time of recording, Eddie Doherty is the last shop in Ireland to weave by hand. We learned about Eddie from an American travel program and had to make the trip to see him.
You know what you've done from that shop yet?
No, yeah, I'm fascinated by it.
Eddie began hand weaving Donegal wool into tweed at the age of 16. That was 60 years earlier, and he's still going. His passion, skill, and warmth are unmistakable.
I call the flame chair. Over my
Yeah, that would take quite a bit of time.
It's just an ancient way of doing it, but
it works.
It works. Yeah.
So you can just adjust as needed.
You can adjust as you want. Very little adjustment, that's why they're left that way. These are solid knots here.
It works again, it works, it doesn't matter what it looks like. It works, it works. <laughs> It comes out as beautiful tweed. <laughs> Now that there, the wool of the wool is still in that, and that there the wool washed and brushed, and it'll be good, soft as water there. Oh, okay, they're finished. I see. Ready to be labeled. The wife comes, labels, they all left. <laughs> Wow, that is amazing.
This is one of the best examples I can show you of why we travel. Eddie is a gem. Those blankets he's wrapping? Oh yeah, they're in our home. A link to Eddie's store is in this episode's description. we turned in our car in Sligo before a train back to Dublin. Clontarf Castle, our home again for a few nights before our cruise, is just really cool. The castle was converted in 1837 from an 1172 castle and has had among its guests Bram Stoker and George Handel. Our room gives a view out over a small inlet with the cruise terminal just 10 minutes away. The Book of Kells, located here at Trinity College, is an early 9th century Latin manuscript of New Testament books Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Dublin Castle opened in 1204. A 1673 fire and remodel result in the building you see now. Until 1922, Dublin Castle was the administrative center of the British government. Grafton Street is a main area of Dublin to shop and watch really great street performers. Kilmainham Jail tells the story, rather somberly in some facets, of the Irish struggle for independence. Jameson Distillery opened in 1780. Active distilling was relocated from this facility in 1976, which is now a museum, showcasing its history and, happily, just as importantly, offering tastings.
So first is the Jameson name. So John Jameson, he's our founder. That's it. Just do it again. Put it in your hands. So it's much more sweeter, very much like drawn flakes or cereals. After hours and hours of heating, heating is stopped and the main body is more acceptable. Very much like rubbing alcohol, some people say hand sanitizer. The tasting glass creates the perfect analyze the whiskey. It's rather than flat or straight, so you'll notice that there's little droplets or residue forming. I don't know what they're called. Yeah, in a lot of places they call the legs. In Ireland though, we're depressing, we call them the tears.
The Irish House Party is conducted several times each week, at time of recording for €25.
How are you all feeling tonight? Did you all enjoy your dinner?
Yes!
We didn't have any dinner, unfortunately.
He left the dead weight scorn, until at last was said by a false-hearted woman. He was cruelly betrayed, was young man on the wall.
An optional dinner on site prior to the show is €50 and includes the performance.
Actually written by a great Australian folk singer. His name is Eric Bogle. Eric did a lot of touring in the 1970s, and he got sick and tired of people just coming up to him, interrupting him all the time on stage, asking, sending up requests to sing Bob Dylan. So he wrote a song called The Dylan Song that he would sing at the start of every show, so nobody would ask him to sing Bob Dylan ever again.
So I struggled on, but the magic was gone. I only felt the deep sense of failure. So I decided to go where all failures go, and I boarded a plane for Australia. When I laugh, it's true. When I landed in Sydney, the sun had shone down on a view that was lovely and thrilling. Upon seeing my case, with a smile on his face, Custom said, "Yes, sing any Dylan, mate."
I said, "No, no, a thousand times no. I'd rather see my own life gone and spilling. I'll sing anything, even God Save the Queen, but I just won't sing any Bob Dylan."
So I tell you now, friends, again and again, I was asked the same flippin' question. And I usually replied in my own quiet way, with a totally indecent suggestion. So all you young folkies who mash out a chord, if you want to take the top billing, just murder good prose, sing through your nose, and then you'll sound just like Bob Dylan.
Epic, the Irish Emigration Museum, shows the history of emigration, sports, science, and music. Thank you. Guinness Storehouse is a 7-story facility where a free pint is included with admission, which at time of recording was 17 euros. Great add-on is the Connoisseur Experience. An additional 48 euros and limited to 14 guests, its 2 hours of beer history and sampling is well worth it. So much so, we returned on another day to do it again.
Ladies and gents, your Connoisseur Experience.
A highlight is getting behind the bar and pouring your own beer.
So the story of Guinness begins in 1759. And the drink we're going to start with today is our Guinness Draught, which we introduced in 1959. So Guinness Draught was introduced to celebrate our 200-year anniversary. The nitrogen gas we use, the bubbles are much smaller. So when they're bursting on our tongue, you barely even notice it at all. And that's what gives Guinness its very smooth, creamy, velvety texture. We're going to take a generous mouthful of the darker liquid. We're going to swirl it around our palates. Then when we swallow the beer, we're going to breathe out your nose. Has anybody learned the Irish word for cheers yet?
Sláinte.
Sláinte, exactly. Or if you're having trouble pronouncing that, just say it's a lawn chair really fast. It's a lawn chair. It's a lawn chair. And sláinte.
The top floor is called the Gravity Bar, where you collect your free pint, as well as perhaps purchase a few more, and from where you get great views of Dublin. We hope you've enjoyed this episode. Please give it a like and consider subscribing. Thank you. In our next episode, we board Celebrity Reflection and visit Cork, Belfast, and Reykjavik. Thank you very much for watching.